Most robot manufacturing applications involve operating on static objects. But what if the part will be moving? How would you program the robot? In this video, I'll show you how you can create a path on a moving object in just a few seconds. The same way we create a path on a static object, we can do so on a moving object. Using RoboDK TwinTrack, we can do so if your measurement system supports tracking multiple objects at the same time. So in this example, we place some sticker targets on the part, and this allows us to track the part in real time. So as we move the object, we should see this reflected in the simulation. So in RoboDK, we receive the coordinate system at the centroid of those targets, and we can add another coordinate system based on certain features, like in this example, 3 points on the part. And we added that object attached to that coordinate system, so we can see the object being tracked in real time accurately. So the procedure is the same as if the object was static. We can just grab the probe, make sure the probe is visible and the part is visible at all times, and press and hold the first button of the probe. Once we have a path, we can see a cloud of points attached to the part. To convert that into a program, we can just place the part somewhere in the robot workspace, press the second button of a probe, and that will be converted into a robot program. We can move the part and see what the robot would do if the part was somewhere else. If there were any program issues, like singularities or axis limits, RoboDK would tell us. So before we run the program on the real robot, we should always make sure that we can properly run it in the current position. So once we've simulated the program in this location, we can just press and hold the second button of a probe, and this will start the program on the real robot. To make sure we maintain a best accuracy, we should make sure we don't move the part or the probe too fast. We should also make sure that if we have a large part, we should make sure we cover a whole area of the part using stickers. Like in this example, we only have a few stickers at the top, at the front of the part, so we're going to be mostly accurate towards the front of the part. We should also make sure that we properly fine-tune the averaging filter to receive poses at the right frequency and with the right average. If you'd like to learn more about RoboDK TwinTrack, follow the product page in the description below.